This is the Scheppach DP60. It's an unusual looking bench drill, but not too dissimilar to the Bosch PBD40. There are some similarities, but there's one big difference. This is on sale in the UK from ALDI, the supermarket chain, for £129, and that compares to almost £300 for the Bosch machine. Now, I'm curious to know whether this is any good. Previous models, the DP40 and the DP50, plus a model that was on sale in Lidl under the brand name Parkside, all received mixed reviews. And one of the things that has been called out is the questionable build quality and its accuracy. So it'd be interesting to know whether this is going to suit my needs. So in this workshop, I'm predominantly concerned with drilling holes into wood and occasionally soft metals like brass or aluminium. Now, as woodworkers, we will use a range of drill bits, from very small ones, 3 to 4 millimeters, up to say 40 millimeters for a force and a bit, and for hole saws, maybe even up to 120 millimeters. And with the change in bit diameter, then you need to adjust the speed of the drill as well. And in this machine of mine, which is a firm FTB 16, that's achieved, like many drill presses, by adjusting the belts at the top of the machine. Now, I like a nice working height, and I've always found changing the belts really awkward. So we all compromise. You do it, I do it, we all do it. We find a speed that tends to work and we stick with it, rather than choosing a speed which is perfect for the bit that we're using. And that's one of the big appeals of these machines. The fact that there's an electronic speed control allows you to precisely dial in the speed of the drilling operation. And that's just what we need. Okay, so perhaps the first thing to mention is that this is actually quite a lightweight bench drill. If you didn't want it permanently fixed to your bench, this is something that you could easily put away, tucked underneath the counter somewhere, and bring out as and when you need it. And it's probably worth saying that perhaps a way of thinking of this machine is very much as a hand drill in a vertical stand. After all, we've got the chuck, above the chuck a gearbox, motor above that, and it's fitted with a speed controller. Now, all of the shafts within the gearbox are relatively short, and if you put your hand on the chuck, you can feel a very small amount of movement in what is a bearing which is immediately above the chuck, just inside the body of the drill. And it's fair to say that when I compare this to my firm drill, which has no discernible movement at all in the chuck, this felt a little bit disappointing out of the box. Okay, so this is the shot for many of you that you've been looking forward to. This is the dial indicator on the drill bit test to have a look at the run out. Let's turn the machine on and take a look. There we go, that's 0.2 millimeters by my reckoning. And I don't think that's too bad. And the thing to say is that, as far as I'm concerned, when I've been using this over the last few weeks, this has been accurate enough. I've got no problems with 0.2 millimeters of run out if what I get in the piece of wood is a straight and accurate hole for what I need. So there we go. Now, this is just a simple twist chuck, and it has a collar which locks and unlocks. And to get the drill bit out, quick twist, and the drill bit is in your hand. I'm not really a terribly big fan of this sort of arrangement. And one of the issues that this drill in particular has is that there's not enough resistance in the motor to stop it turning. If you think about a hand drill, that's actually quite an easy operation to do. The motor's locked whilst you're trying to change the drill bit. I have to say, I'm not entirely blown away with its design. Thinking about it, a lot of other drill presses will have that sort of three-armed arrangement on the side. And in fact, on the Bosch, there's this wheel which just looks crazy to me. And then you have this clamp here, and the clamp allows you to raise and lower the whole motor and drill assembly. and at its highest point you've got somewhere in the region of 25 centimeters below the chuck. But I found this perfectly usable for most of the drilling that I've had to do in the last couple of weeks since I've had this machine. So now let's look at work holding. There's our bit of wood. So it comes with a fence which slides up and down in these slots. I quite like it. It works well, tightened up. It's a nice surface to reference your work against. So if you're like me and like to clamp your work, then this clamp works very well, quite solid. So the one problem with the clamp is that if you're using larger diameter Forstner bits, then the clamp is going to interfere with the bit when you try and drill. So the way around that is to put the fence back in and then effectively clamp to the fence. So the drill actually has two on buttons. The first on button is here, that turns on the display. The second on button is here, and that turns on the drill. So the display either shows revolutions per minute, as in here, or we press this button and then it shows the depth. Zero that, and then we can see the depth change as we move the drill up and down. Okay, so on the display here we have another button which turns on a laser. Now, one of the challenges that I find with most lasers is that inevitably when you put the drill bit in, it sort of gets in the way. Personally, it's not really for me. I tend to have the laser turned off. On the front of the machine, we have this knob here. This controls the speed. So down to 180 revolutions per minute. And up to 880. And one of the things that I'm not too impressed with here is that the machine is actually quite noisy. And I think that a lot of that comes down to the gearbox. The gearbox just makes an incredible racket. On the side here, we have a switch. Allows you to go from gear one, which is high torque, low speed, to gear two, which is low torque, high speed. And we go from around 550 revolutions per minute to 2,500 revolutions per minute. So that's all the speeds I think you're going to ever need in a range of materials. On the side here, we have a lever that allows us to set a physical depth stop. And if we combine that with the readout on the front, we can actually set a very accurate and repeatable drilling depth. So what do I think of this? Well, I think overall, this is a very good choice for somebody that's looking for a budget drill press for their workshop, especially if you're mostly concerned with drilling holes vertically into wood. The gearbox is noisy, and that's one area of disappointment for me. I don't like the fact that we have to turn it on in two places, but again, maybe that's something I can live with. The overall build quality is good enough, although there are some indications on the castings that they haven't really taken a great deal of care to finish many of the parts in the factory. But there's nothing particularly dangerous about any of the edges. It all looks perfectly acceptable. And the paint finish and the general quality and flatness of the table is good enough. Obviously, this only drills vertical holes. If you're looking for something that's got a sort of tilting table for angled holes, then maybe this isn't really going to be the first choice for you. I think you'd grow tired of creating a sort of secondary platform underneath this to get the angles that you want. But for my needs, in particular, given the fact that I spend 99.9% of my time drilling vertical holes into wood, this is probably good enough. And yes, a machine like this is a suitable replacement for my firm drill press, which is a drill press that I've had difficulties with ever since I've had it. So there we go. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. I'll leave a link below to this machine on ALDI's website if it's still there. If you're looking at this a little bit further down the road, it may well have gone off sale. So I hope that's been of interest to you. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't, and there'll be more woodworking videos from me, Carl, in the Strawbite workshop. But for now, cheerio.